My child is immunocompromised. Do I still get them vaccinated? Excellent question. We have seen throughout this pandemic that people who are immunocompromised end up with more severe illness, meaning that they end up getting sicker, they end up getting hospitalized at much higher rates than people who are not immunocompromised. So what does it mean to be immunocompromised? It means that you have a weakened immune system for whatever reason. So it's very, very important for people with weakened immune systems to get vaccinated so that they don't end up getting sicker or they don't end up getting hospitalized due to COVID-19.
Can my kid get their vaccines at the same time they get their other shots? That's a great question because the CDC has actually reminded us that kids and adults both can get multiple vaccines at the same time. And by that, I mean you can get your COVID vaccine as well as your influenza vaccine or other vaccine that it's needed. It's safe, the vaccine will be effective and will protect you against COVID-19. My 8-year-old has asthma. Can she still get vaccinated? And again, that's another very good question. And the reason why is a good question is because especially kids with other conditions such as asthma or diabetes or any other health problems should be vaccinated. These kids may have a greater potential of being hospitalized if infected with COVID-19. And I think it's a great reminder for parents with kids that have other conditions to get them vaccinated and protected against COVID-19.
Kids don't get sick with COVID as adults. Why should my kid get the vaccine? So it is true that kids do not get as sick as adults with COVID. However, we have seen kids get sick. We should also talk about the importance of getting vaccinated so that we don't end up with kids getting really sick and being hospitalized. So it's a plea again to get the pediatric population vaccinated. I'm scared about serious side effects for my child, like heart inflammation. Why gamble and get my kid vaccinated so young? That's a very good question. We have seen young males come up with inflammation of the heart following mRNA vaccines. What I will say is that it is incredibly rare. And then what I should also say is that your child has about 5 to 8 times higher likelihood of getting inflammation of the heart, which is also called myocarditis, perimyocarditis, if they were to get COVID-19 than getting that side effect from the vaccine. I think it's a safer bet to get vaccinated so that they don't end up with a 5 to 8 times chance of getting inflammation of the heart. So very good question, very good concern, and at the same time, they are better protected if they're vaccinated.
Where do I go to get my kid vaccinated? That's a great question because there are many places throughout the state that can provide a child with a vaccine. So, for example, your pediatrician should be able to provide vaccines. Pharmacies have the ability to vaccinate kids. And there are many different areas and in the state of Oregon that will have vaccines for kids. And these vaccines will be available just about anywhere.
So what I will add is that there are CBOs, community-based organizations, that are also running vaccine clinics, and they are continuing to do so. So I would say reach out to the Oregon Health Authority or to your local county authority, and they will have information as to which CBOs in your area are running vaccine clinics. How should I protect my vulnerable family members now that masking rules are changing?
You wear a mask when you think there may be a chance that you could get infected. So keep that in mind because you end up going home to a family member that's vulnerable, that should be vaccinated, but possibly not fully protected. Therefore, the use of the mask is really kind of the key here, vaccination and masking. Will there be more variants in the future, and how can we protect our families?
I love that question because it speaks to what we can do, what we have in our control, right? So what can we do? Getting vaccinated is by far the most important thing we can do to ensure that we don't get new variants. So everybody who's eligible for a vaccine, please get vaccinated so that we don't end up with new variants.
We will see new variants. That, yes, there's a large subset of the population throughout the world that is not vaccinated and potentially creating new variants, and that we will continue to see, much like we see a new variant of the flu every year. That is not going to change. Why even get vaccinated if there will be more variants? You know, that's a great question, because as we said before, variants are created because people are not vaccinated. So the best way to prevent this creation of new variants throughout the world is really to get vaccinated, period.
Thumbs up. So I love this question. Will COVID-19 ever end? That's a loaded question. All things come to an end, right? Ultimately, yes. The question is, how soon is that going to happen? And that has a lot to do with how we do things as a society. Are we going to practice all those COVID protective behaviors that ensure that this comes to an end at a much quicker rate than not?
No, I agree. It's not whether it's going to end or not. It's how we can protect ourselves and protect our families, and how to get vaccinated and have equity in terms of vaccines throughout the world. Those are all so important, and that will help us end the pandemic if that's ever possible. But we have to think about what we can do now so we can start moving forward.
I think it highlights how exhausted we've become, how we're experiencing COVID fatigue as a society, as a global society, actually. And the most important thing you can do right now is get vaccinated so that this comes to an end sooner rather than later.
Go to SafeStrongOregon.org to hear doctors answer your questions about COVID vaccines.